where did the idea for Suki come from?
I got the idea because I started trying, I didn't want to write a series based from the vampire's point of view, and I like to write in first person. It gives me a sense of immediacy. So I wanted to write about someone who was dating a vampire. And I thought I would write about a young woman who was dating a vampire, and I had to think of a good reason for a sensible, hardworking young woman to do such a crazy thing.
Right.
So that's how I built her character from there.
So you didn't want her to be flighty?
No.
Yeah.
No, I wanted her to have her feet on the ground, but at the same time face a big set of problems, which, you know, I'm afraid most all my heroines face a big set of problems.
You guys put them through the ringer.
We do.
Through the ringer.
We do. Jim Butcher and I have a contest to see who can put their protagonist through the worst set of stuff.
So, you know what I forgot that I wanted to ask you? You wrote a couple of mystery series before you finally broke out. I mean, how many books was it before you really hit it big?
Well, I've been in the business for 29 years now, and I've been writing the Suki books for, well, let's say 12, because I wrote the first book, and it took 2 years to get it published. Nobody wanted it. It got turned down over and over. Yeah, it is.
And now you're like...
Vindication City. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I was going to say a bad word, but I won't.
No, it's like, neener.
Yeah, so what advice would you have for someone, not only aspiring, but, you know, those mid-list authors? The mid-list is kind of getting
decimated. I was on the mid-list for many, many years, and I got cut a couple of times. So I know I've been there.
Yeah.
I think you have to really have faith in yourself, and you have to really... use all your judgment and all your ability to write the best possible book you can write. And then you just have to work hard to try to get it to the eyes of somebody who's going to see it. And even then, sometimes it may not work.
So did you always know you were going to hit it big?
Oh, gosh, no.
No. Some people say that. They're like, I knew it. I knew it was going to happen.
No, I didn't. I just thought, you know, if I could just make $25,000 a year, I would be so happy. Because my husband's a chemical engineer, so he, you know, we always had a decent income, thank God. And then I thought, oh man, if I could just make $50,000 a year, I would feel like I had it made for life. But you know, it just kept going after that.